MRC JEE and State Engineering JEE exams require in-depth knowledge of the subjects. GradeUp, India's largest exam preparation platform, brings to you a dedicated YouTube channel for RRB JEE and SSC JEE aspirants. Subscribe to GradeUp RRB JEE and SSC JEE exam channel today and stay updated for the exam. Preparation of RRB JEE, SSC JEE and other exams like DMRC JEE and State Engineering JEE exams require in-depth knowledge of the subjects. GradeUp, India's largest exam preparation platform, brings to you a dedicated YouTube channel for RRB JEE and SSC JEE aspirants. Subscribe to GradeUp RRB JEE and SSC JEE exam channel today and stay updated for the exam. Preparation of RRB JEE, SSC JEE and other exams like DMRC JEE and State Engineering JEE exams require in-depth knowledge of the subjects. GradeUp, India's largest exam preparation platform, brings to you a dedicated YouTube channel for RRB JEE and SSC JEE aspirants. Subscribe to GradeUp RRB JEE and SSC JEE exam channel today and stay updated for the exam. Preparation of RRB JEE, SSC JEE and other exams like DMRC JEE and State Engineering JEE exams require in-depth knowledge of the subjects. GradeUp, India's largest exam preparation platform, brings to you a dedicated YouTube channel for RRB JEE and SSC JEE aspirants. Subscribe to GradeUp RRB JEE and SSC JEE exam channel today and stay updated for the exam. Okay, good evening, my dear students. Welcome to GradeUp, India's biggest e-learning platform. So I welcome you all to this live session of the Theory of Machine Velocity Analysis Part 2. So I hope so. In the previous session, we have discussed about the first part of velocity analysis. So I hope so, and you have understood, and you have also solved some problem from your side, so that you have cleared your concept. Okay. Good evening, Avinash. Okay, it's looping. Now it's clear. Now the session is being live. Now let us start today's session. In the previous session, we have discussed about the instantaneous center method. Now today, in today's session, we'll be talking about the second method, which is a relative velocity method, and that method is basically the graphical approach. Okay, that method is basically the graphical approach. Good evening, Neha. Good evening, Ramasin, Krishna Reddy. I welcome you all. Prakash, good evening. Now, if I talk about ESE point of view, a question you can definitely expect from a topic which is the relative velocity method, because this topic is one of the most important topic if I talk about the ESE conventional point of view. And sometimes you can expect a shortcut method, because sometimes a question from this topic, let us suppose it is being asked in the problem, what is the velocity of a link? So you can either go for instantaneous center method, or you can go for your relative velocity method. Now, students are definitely, most of the time, they are preferring instantaneous over relative method. But in today's session, in the end, we'll be discussing a problem in which we'll be using the relative velocity method, which is highly useful in that problem. So you need to identify which of the problem you need to proceed by instantaneous center or by the relative velocity method. So be till the end of the session. We'll be having some one question discussion that is very useful for the exam preparation. So I welcome you all to this live session. Now let us introduce myself. My name is Suraj Gopi. As you all know, like those who are new to the session, my name is Suraj Gopi. I have 5+ of experience. I have expertise in, I usually take the subjects of mechanics, thermal engineering, heat transfer, industrial engineering and theory of machine. And I again welcome you to this great GradeUp platform, so that you will be enjoying the live session which we are conducting every day at 9 o'clock. And tomorrow also, if I talk about the tomorrow session, tomorrow we'll be having a post-gate analysis. So everybody is requested, you will be attended to that session, because that is very useful for the gate aspirants, what should be done after gate. Okay, so that will be discussed in tomorrow's session. Now let us discuss today's, let us start today's session. Now in the starting also, I told you today's session will be talking about the relative velocity method. Now let us understand what is relative velocity. what do you mean by relative velocity, and how to tackle with the problem, because normally 80% of the students usually don't prefer graphical approach. That's a fact that most of the students are definitely going for the analytical approach, which is the instantaneous center method, and they are not preferring the graphical approach. But my dear students, some of the problems you need to go for the graphical approach. So we'll be discussing what is this graphical approach. Now let us understand relative velocity. Let us assume there is one link AB. Let us suppose there is one link AB, and it is rotated with an omega or angular velocity of omega. Okay, this is omega AB. This angular velocity AB. Now, if I want to calculate what is the relative velocity of point A with respect to B, if I want to calculate what is the your relative velocity of point A with respect to B, that will be a velocity which is perpendicular to this direction. Obviously, you all know, if I want to have, let us suppose I'm having a body which is rotating like this. This is point O and this is point A. If I want to calculate what is the relative, what is the velocity at point A, for getting to know what is the velocity at point A, you need to draw a perpendicular line in the direction of rotation. This will be giving the direction of VAO or OA. Precisely, it should be OA. Velocity of point A with respect to point O. Fine, velocity of point A with respect to point O, that is a relative velocity. Similarly, if I am having an omega like this, let us suppose in anticlockwise direction, then the velocity will be in VAB like this. This will be the direction. So always remember, whenever a body is moving in a rotational direction or a circular motion, so the tangent, you need to draw a tangent or perpendicular line to that point, that will be giving the relative velocity with respect to that fixed point. Understood? It's a basic thing. You might have always know this from the class 12th onwards. You are studying circular motion. So if I want to have now, very good question from Manish. Why 90 degree? Because always you always know, if a body is rotating, at every point it is changing its direction. If I suppose, let us assume a body is rotating. Let us suppose a body is rotating like this. Okay, so this is the path. Let us suppose this body is rotating. So at each and every point, the direction of the velocity is changing. Okay, the direction of the velocity is changing. Fine. So can anyone tell me, if I talk about a circular motion, which force is responsible for the circular motion? Anyone who can tell me which of the forces is responsible for the circular motion? Is this centripetal or centrifugal? I told in one of my session, which of the force is responsible for the circular motion? Anyone who can tell me, we are having good number live with us. If let us suppose there is a string, and at the end of the string, I'm rotating this stone. Fine. At the end of this string, I've tied a stone and I'm rotating like this. Okay. So can anyone tell me which force is responsible for the circular motion? Anyone? Is it centripetal or centrifugal? It's basically centripetal. Very good. It's centripetal force. That is a real force. And what is centrifugal force? Centrifugal force is the pseudo force. Please, because in one time in SSC, a question being asked, which is a pseudo force. So centrifugal force is a pseudo force, and centripetal force is basically the real force. That means the force which is responsible for the circular motion is basically your centripetal force. Is that clear? Exactly. Very good. Now, how to solve, how to relate this topic with our theory of machine? Let us understand with a diagram. Let us understand with a diagram, and we'll be having a velocity diagram of this of this configuration diagram. We'll be drawing a velocity diagram so that you can understand how to draw a velocity diagram, and from that velocity triangle, how to calculate the velocity. Okay. Now, let us suppose we are having a, this is basically known as configuration diagram. What is configuration diagram? This is basically the link assembly. So we are having a link. Can anyone tell me how many links are there? How many number of links are there in this arrangement? If I talk about this configuration, anyone who can tell me how many number of links are there? There basically, the first is, this is link one, which is fixed. This is link two. This is link number three. This is link number 4, this is again link 1, which is fixed. This is link number 5, this is link number 6, and this is again link number 1. So basically, in total, we are having 6 links. Very good, Madhu. We are having total 6 links which is shown in this diagram. So now in this diagram, using this diagram, we'll be drawing the velocity triangle. Ajay, no, it's six number of links, because the fixed part will be taken as a single link, because all the fixed part will be taken as a single link. Okay, so this point and this point is basically will be acted as a single link, because that is a fixed link. Okay, that is a fixed, because fixed is considered to be a single link. Now how to draw the velocity triangle? Now you all know, let us suppose this link OA is rotating with a omega in a clockwise direction. Let us suppose your link OA is rotating in a clockwise direction, and you need to draw the velocity triangle for the entire link. Clear? Yes, Sudha, Madhu, tell me, what is your doubt? Look, now this link OA is rotating with an, if I draw only this, this is your O, this is your A. If this is rotating with an angular velocity of omega, let us suppose this is given. Fine. Now, can anyone tell me what will be the velocity A? What will be the velocity A? Anyone who can tell me what will be the velocity A and what should be the direction? It should be downward or upward. You will be telling me, because I have given you at point 4, why we are considering as one link? At point 4, because this is your single link. It's already given in the statement. This BC is a single link. Okay. This BC is a single link, and intermediate we are attaching a single hinge point. Now, if I want to calculate what is the velocity of point A, that will be omega into the distance OA. Omega into the distance OA, that will be giving the linear velocity. And what should be the direction? I just now told you the direction of this velocity will be like this. The direction of velocity will be, yes, exactly. Very good. So direction will be downward. Okay. Now, I know the omega value and the length value will be given in the problem. So you have calculated the magnitude of VA. You have calculated the magnitude of VA. Let us suppose this magnitude is coming out to be 20 meter per second. Let us suppose I'm taking a rough value. You are getting 20 meter per second as the magnitude of VA. Now, next step will be, you will be taking a scale. You'll be taking a scale, because this is a graphical approach. You need to understand what is the difference between graphical approach and an analytical approach. Okay. Now, scale I'm taking is, let us suppose 20 meter per second. 20 meter per second is equal to 1 centimeter. Let us suppose 20 meter per second is equal to 1 centimeter. Okay. Now, if 20 meter per second is 1 centimeter, so I'll be taking a point O, and always remember one thing, the notation, because in ESE convention papers, rotation do have a weightage. Okay. Now, when you see this configuration diagram, all the notations are in capital letter. So when you'll be drawing a velocity diagram, all the notation you'll be taking as a small alphabets. Okay, in small alphabets. Now this is O, this is A. Let us suppose this distance is 1 centimeter. This is point A. This is your VA. Okay, and you have measured this. This is equal to 1 centimeter, because I have taken a scale. You can also take a scale. If you want, you can take 20 meter per second as 2 centimeter. It's up to you. So I've taken 1 centimeter, because I know the magnitude, I know the direction also. Rest, I don't know the magnitude, I don't know the direction. That will be calculating by using the velocity triangle. Okay. Now, tell me, if this is rotating clockwise, if this OA is rotating clockwise, tell me what will be the direction of link number 6. If this OA link is rotating in a clockwise fashion, tell me what will be the movement of link number 6 with respect to ground. Tell me what will be the movement of link number 6, that is a slider, with respect to your ground. Will it be left side or right side? Just try to analyze it. If this is rotating, okay, this will be pushing. Fine. If this is pushing in this direction, So it will be having left side or right side. Very good, Archana. Very good, Justin. Rashad, very good. Ajay Yadav, very good. Obviously, you just need to imagine, you just visualize it. If this O is rotating in a clockwise fashion, what will happen? This is hinge over this. So it will be rotating like this. Fine. If it is rotating like this, it will be moving over this direction. So it will be moving in this direction. So that means your, and this is point O is fixed. Let us suppose this point is A, B, C. This is point D. Let us suppose this point is D. So this, I can take this as small d, this is in this direction. And I don't know the magnitude. I don't know the magnitude, I don't only know the direction. So what I will do, so I'll be drawing a dotted line. Because I know it's on the left hand side, I'll be drawing on the left hand side of this. So because this is the fixed point, the point D, O and point E also will be at the same point. Is that clear? Understood? Now, if it is rotating clockwise, what will happen? This will be moving downward. This will be moving upward. If this is moving upward, what will happen? This will be moving on the left hand side. So this will be on the left hand side. Abhishek Kushwa, I suppose now your doubt is clear why this is moving in the left hand side direction. Is that clear? Not left to right. It will be towards left. Just try to imagine if this is rotating, fine, on the clockwise direction. So what will happen? It will try to push this link like this. If this is pushing, it will be trying to move in the upward direction. If it is moving in the upward direction, it will act like a seesaw. It will moving to the left hand side or the your anti-clockwise fashion. If it is moving in the anti-clockwise fashion, your D will be moving towards left. Why point E is considered? E is considered because E is also a fixed point. So we can take all the fixed point as a single point, DOE. We'll be taking all the fixed point as the fixed point DOE. Now, you know the direction, so I've marked it dotted line towards left. Okay, now next is this link. Let us take this link CD. Okay, now link CD, if I want to calculate what is the velocity of point C, we'll be drawing a perpendicular line. Obviously, we'll be drawing a perpendicular line like this. That will be giving the velocity of point C with respect to point this point D. Is that clear? So if I want to calculate this point will be having a velocity. Let us suppose I don't know what is the direction. So I've marked a dotted line. Clear? Fine. Next is the BC, the link BC. The velocity of link BC will be perpendicular to that line and will be passing through point E. Please, this is the most important point for understanding the relative velocity term. Now, if you take this link B to C, it's a single link. The velocity of this link will be perpendicular to this and also it will be passing through point E. So, I'll be drawing a line which is perpendicular to this and passing through this point. Is that clear? So, you just got a triangle. This triangle is your, this is point, your, this is your D, this is your A, B, C, D, E, F. Let us suppose this is F. Okay, so this is your F, this is point D, fine, and this is point C. Is that clear? Is that clear how we are getting this triangle? Please respond, please tell me, because this is the most important part. If you're not able to understand, please tell me. This is your VFC. F is the fixed point, your D is this slider. Got this triangle? This is still a dotted line. Okay, now from point A to B, we'll be drawing a perpendicular line. This will be perpendicular to this line. So just draw a perpendicular line. The intersection point will be point E, point this point, which is B. Fine. So this completes your velocity triangle. Okay. This is your VB. This is your VAB. Is that clear? सीडी में वेरी डिपेंडिंग ऑन द वेलोसिटी ऑफ डी. सीडी में वेरी डिपेंड ऑन द वेलोसिटी ऑफ डी. यस डेफिनेटली ऑल आर लिंक्ड, ऑल आर डिपेंडेंट लिंक, ऑल आर डिपेंडिंग टू ईच अदर. सो बिकॉज द इनपुट इज गिवन, इनपुट इज गिवन ओवर हियर ओ ए. सो that is only we are controlling, rest it is basically dependent on this omega only. Okay, now let us take one doubt from Abhishek. Can you explain the link CD? Yes, definitely I can definitely explain once again. Now you know this point, the velocity of point D will be in this line because it's a reciprocating motion and it's also moving in the left hand direction. So I've marked a dotted line. I don't know the magnitude. Okay, next is CD. CD I know the velocity will be, the velocity will be like this because this is moving in the anticlockwise fashion. So velocity of point C with respect to D will be downward. So I've drawn it like this. The velocity will be somewhere around here. I don't know the magnitude. Next is the velocity of point B with respect to point C will be passing through point E. So we'll be having a line perpendicular to this, passing through this point, a dotted line. So you got a triangle. This is the first velocity triangle. And you need to measure the dimension of this. Let us suppose the dimension of, let us suppose CF is coming out to be 3 centimeter. Let us suppose your CF is coming out to be 3 centimeter. Tell me what is the velocity of point C. Tell me what is the magnitude of FC. Quickly tell me if the if in the problem you have drawn the velocity triangle. And let us suppose CF, you are getting the scaling, the dimension of CF length is equal to 3 centimeter. In that case, the velocity F C, it's not F C, is basically C F. F C, because it's moving in the downward direction. This is the velocity direction. So F C is equal to 60 meter per second. Where will be the velocity at E? At E, it's a fixed point. E is a fixed point. If any link is a fixed point, we'll be taking entire link to be a single. In this configuration diagram, we are having three fixed points. That is point A, point E, and point F. These are the three fixed points. So point A, point E, and point F will be taken at as a single link, which is the fixed link. Which is the fixed link. So I've taken point O, point E, and point F to be a single link. Is that clear? So by using this approach, you need to draw a velocity triangle, and from the velocity triangle, you will be scaling out and you'll be getting the magnitude of the velocity. Link AB. Okay, let us take link AB. AB is this link. This is your AB link. Now, if you want to calculate velocity A with respect to B, you'll be measuring this length. Let us suppose this length is coming out to be 3.5. Let us suppose the length is 3.5. So this will be 3.5 into 3.5 centimeter into 20. That will be your 70 meter per second. Link AB once again. Okay, fine. Link AB once again. Because this is very important if I'm talking about ESC conventional point of view. And I'll be after this, I'll be taking a question where we'll be solving a problem where you can go for either instantaneous approach or you can go for a relative velocity approach. I'll be solving by both the methods and you will be telling me which of the method is beneficial for you. Now let us take Neha Moria's doubt, how we are drawing for link AB. Now this is clear. This is clear. Now you have drawn this dotted line. Okay, you have drawn this dotted line and I don't know what is the magnitude. What is the magnitude? You know only this. So this is the line. Fine. Now what you will be doing, you will be drawing the AB line and that will be passing through point A. So you will be drawing a line perpendicular to this. Same line will be shifted. You will be drawing a line perpendicular to this. Perpendicular to this. And the intersection point of these two lines will be point B. And this is your velocity triangle for VAB. This is your velocity B. This is your velocity AB. Clear, Neha? Clear? This is very important. Why I've taken this session particularly because some of the students are having a doubt how to draw the velocity triangle. And in this case, I've taken a more complex diagram so that you can understand how to draw the velocity triangle. Okay? Always remember, you need to take the perpendicular direction. क्लियर? एनी डाउट प्लीज टेल मी. वंस एक्सप्लेन वन लास्ट टाइम, इज इट वी बी ए और वी ए बी? वेलोसिटी ऑफ ए विद रिस्पेक्ट टू बी, दिस इज इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन राइट, सो दिस विल बी वेलोसिटी ऑफ बी विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ए, बिकॉज वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द वेलोसिटी ऑफ दिस पॉइंट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस पॉइंट, वेलोसिटी ऑफ बी विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ए. इफ आई टॉक अबाउट दिस, दिस विल वेलोसिटी ऑफ, वेलोसिटी ऑफ, लेट मी यूज अनदर मार्कर, दिस विल बी वेलोसिटी ऑफ पॉइंट सी बिकॉज आई एम कैलकुलेटिंग दिस विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एफ. क्लियर? Direction of AB and CF. Now I have clear. Take this point, final velocity with respect to this point, VBA. This is the velocity triangle. This is very important for ESC objective point of view, because we'll be in every exam you can expect a problem from this topic, and in ESC conventional definitely a problem from this topic. Pillu mane, once again graphical method. Very basic. Let us suppose omega is given. Okay, this is the velocity will be perpendicular to this. This will be the velocity of VA. This will be VA. So I've drawn this VA and scaled this 20 meter per second is equal to 1 centimeter. Next is because I know the moment of this. I know the moment of your D, because D will be moving towards left hand side. Because if this is moving in the clockwise direction, this will be moving downward. This will be moving upward. If this is moving upward, this will be moving downward. So this will be moving on the left hand side. Fine, if this is on the left hand side, so this is your velocity on the left hand side, and I don't know the magnitude, so I have defined the direction, dotted line. Okay, this will be towards the left. And please make sure, whenever you are drawing any velocity triangle, you need to take all the fixed link as a single point, then only you will be able to draw it. If not, it's very difficult. Okay, so you have taken O, F and E. O, F and E. These are fixed point as a single point. Fine. So you have drawn this dotted line. After this, you know CD. CD is moving in the downward direction. That is like this. Your velocity will be in the downward direction. I have drawn a dotted line. Dotted line. Next, the velocity of point B with respect to C will be in this direction, perpendicular to this. But this point will be passing through point E. So we'll be having a perpendicular direction passing through point E. So this triangle is the velocity triangle. This you have already drawn. Fine, this is your dotted line, velocity of point B with respect to A, this is the perpendicular direction, intersection point will be point B, this is your second velocity triangle. Clear? Clear how to draw the velocity triangle, because this is very, very beneficial for solving some problem. Let us take, this is the same thing, this is the procedure, you have to only always take a link perpendicular to the link, any of the link. The direction of velocity, linear velocity will always be perpendicular to that link. The direction will be depending in which direction that is rotating. Clear? Fine. The same thing it's written. This is the final velocity triangle which we have understood just now. The same velocity triangle. This is your smaller and this is your bigger. Clear? The velocity triangle. The velocity of B with respect to A, because it's in this direction. Velocity A. This is velocity D with respect to C. And always remember, whenever you are drawing the velocity triangle, in the velocity triangle, you need to mark like this. You need to mention as a vector. Then only your answer will be correct. Okay. You need to draw this vector sign or else you will be losing some mark in the conventional paper. Okay. Now let us solve one problem and we'll be understanding it, how to solve with instantaneous method and how to solve by using relative velocity method. Now, there is a configuration. These two are parallel. Okay. Omega, let us suppose this is link 1, this is link 2, link 3 and link 4. Omega 2 is given as 5 radian per second in clockwise direction. You have to calculate what will be omega 3. What will be omega, sorry, not omega 3, omega 4. What will be omega 4? What will be omega 4? You need to calculate. Now, let us try to calculate by using the instantaneous center method. How to solve by using instantaneous center method? You need to locate all the 6 ICs, all the 6, because there is 4 links, n is equal to 4, the number of ICs will be, how many number of ICs? N into n minus 1 by 2, we have discussed in the previous class. So this will be 2 into 3, 6. 6 ICs will be there. Okay, 6 ICs, you have to locate, this will be your
I 2, 3. This will be I 3, 4. This will be I 1, 4. And there are 6 ICs. That means you will be having I 1, 2, I 1, 3, I 1, 4, I 2, 3, I 2, 4, and I 3, 4. Out of which you have got the location of I 1, 2, I 2, 3, I 3, 4, and I 1, 4. You need to get the location of I 1, 3, and 2, 4. And for the calculation of omega 4, you need to use the angular theorem, the angular velocity. sir, we don't know the magnitude of OD and DC. Magnitude of OD and DC, which one? The previous one, okay. We don't know the magnitude of, let us take this diagram, OD and DC, A, B, C. We don't know the, yes, we don't know, but we know the direction. We know the direction. Okay, we know the direction. So, I have not taken the magnitude. I have taken only the direction. I have taken a cross-section line that will be giving. Is that clear? Now, how to solve this? Yes, tell me how to solve it. Now, for getting the location of I 1, 3 and 1, 2, you need to draw a circle, 4 number of links, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 3 will be 1, 4 and 3, 4. And 1, 2, and 2, 3. Clear? Yes, we can solve it graphically also. I'm telling you both the methods. I'm telling you both the approaches. Okay, Benny, what is your doubt? So different values for same link will be getting. Let us take this out, then we take coming back to this previous problem. Okay, let us try to solve this, then we again coming back to that discussion. Now, I 1, 3, 1, 4 and 3, 4. So, this is 1, 4 and 3, 4. This is the line. 1, 2 and 2, 3. So, tell me what is the location of I 1, 3? Tell me what is the location of I 1, 3? What is the location of I 1, 3? It will be in the infinite. I 1, 3 will be tending to infinity. Clear? Next is 2, 4. So, you got this. So, 2, 4. You can go for 1, 2, 1, 4. 1, 2, 1, 4. And next is 2, 3, 3, 4. 2, 3, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 4. This line. 2, 3, 3, 4. So, we'll be having a intersection point like this. So, if I draw, it will be this point will be I 2 4. Is that clear? I 2 4 you got it. Now I 2 4 you got, you can use the angular velocity theorem. You got angular velocity theorem. So you will be using omega 2 I 2 4 I 1 2 is equal to omega 4 I 2 4 I 1 4. By using this, taking the dimension, you can get the value of omega 4. Very basic. Fine, but it takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of time if you are going with that approach. It takes a lot of time if you are going with this approach, that is the instantaneous center. Now, let us try to understand and solve this problem graphically. Okay, just try to solve this problem graphically. Okay, fine. So, I will be drawing the same diagram. And we will be trying to solve it graphically and you guys will be telling me. This is your link 1, this is your link 2, link 3, link 4 and 10 meter and 3 meter. This is 10 meter, this is 3 meter and this is omega 2 which is equal to 5 radian per second.
and this is omega 3, which you need to calculate. Which you need to calculate. Okay.
Fine. Now, some of the nomenclature were given. This is point O A B. Point O A B and C. So tell me how many fixed points. There are two fixed points, O and C. So I'll be drawing O and C as the same point. Tell me what is the direction of velocity of point A with respect to point O. Tell me what is the direction of velocity of point A with respect to point O. Will it be towards right or will it be towards left? What will be the velocity of point A with respect to point O? Obviously, very good, Archana. Justin, Madhu, very good. It will be towards right. Obviously, it will be towards right. This is moving in a clockwise direction. So, velocity will be like this. This is your VA. So, this will be your VA. This is point A because we know the magnitude VA. We know the magnitude. Fine. How it could be left? If this is moving in the clockwise direction, so the velocity will be a perpendicular direction from this point. This is the velocity at point A towards right. Fine. So, this is your velocity vector VA. Tell me what is the direction of, I don't know the magnitude. I don't know the magnitude. What will be the velocity of point B with respect to point C? What will be what will be the velocity of point B with respect to point C? It will also be in the right hand direction. The point C, this will be point B. Fine. So what you got, your velocity A and velocity B are exactly same. Velocity B and velocity A are exactly same. Fine. If this is exactly same, then you can directly go for this approach. Omega 2 into OA is equal to omega 3 into CB. Clear? So, omega 2 is 10, 5. 5 into 10. 5 into 10 is equal to omega 3 into 3. So, omega 3 is 50 by 3, which is 16.67 radian per second. Is that clear? So, you have now understood how your relative velocity is making the solution very easier. Like this, if this question is coming in your GATE examination, SSC or any examination, you won't be preferring the incidence center method. You will definitely going with the relative velocity method. Now, I'll be telling you a shortcut. Whenever a question is coming where the links are perpendicular to each other, when the links are perpendicular to each other, in that case, you will definitely go for relative velocity method. Damn sure if you're getting a question when the links are like this, parallel to each other, that means like this. Perpendicular to the base or parallel to each other, in that case we'll be definitely will be using the relative velocity method. Now, how to calculate distance I24 I12 in this problem? If you're going with this, in that case you will be giving, let me draw it for you guys, those who want to solve by instantaneous center method. In that case, you will be using the similar triangle approach for getting the distance. For getting the distance, you will be solving. Okay, so this is point O, this is point A, this is point B, this is point C, and this is 10, this is 3. So, you will be using the similar triangle approach. Let us suppose this is I24. Yes, I24. So, this will be 7. This will be 3, this is 7, okay, this angle, let us suppose this is theta, and in that case, you need to get one more dimension or else you won't be able to solve it. You need to get one more dimension or else you won't be able to solve it. Clear? Obviously, how the student is asking a problem, how point A and B are at the same point. Definitely that will be at the same location. How it could be a triangle, velocity triangle? How it could be a velocity triangle? Because please look at this. What is the relative velocity of A with respect to B? This is also in this direction. Just look at this. Those who are having a confusion, how point A and B are the same point. We know this VB will be in this direction. Okay, this VA is in this direction and its magnitude is constant. That means the relative velocity of B with respect to A is zero. Are you getting my point? The relative velocity of point B with respect to A, because there is no relative velocity. If B is moving like this, A is moving like this, with a constant velocity, both the relative velocity will be zero. That is why I have taken A and B at the same point. Is that clear? Is that clear? Why I have taken point B and point A at the same location? Because the relative, because what is AB? If I take this, this is a velocity of B with respect to point A. If A is moving with 10 meter per second at a constant velocity and B is moving with a 5 meter per second with a constant velocity, what is the relative velocity of B with respect to A? That will be exactly equal to zero. This is the same concept. Two trains are moving parallel to each other with the same velocity. Is that clear? So that is why I have taken B and A as the same location. Clear? Got it? If I have taken this B and A at the same location, so you can directly say VA is equal to VB and you can go for this approach. Clear? So you need to solve some problems. You need to apply the concept of relative velocity in some of the problems. And definitely, just I said you, whenever you are getting a configuration like this, you need to approach the relative velocity concept, then only you will be able to understand it clearly. You will be able to solve it in a quick manner. Definitely, you can solve it by instantaneous center method. In that case, what will happen? Your time consuming will be there. You definitely solve by instantaneous center method, but it will be a time consuming approach. So why to waste that time? Okay. Take one more example. Taking only this, let us take, try to solve it. I can give you one homework type if you want. I can give you one homework. You just try to solve it and tell me what is the answer. Because I've taken this example, only one example where you can definitely, which method do you suggest to use in examination to save time? Justin, if you are getting a configuration like this, in that scenario, you need to apply the relative velocity method. And if you are getting a normal configuration where it's having some angle, in that case, you need to calculate or you need to solve. Fine. One more example for graphical method. Let us take one Neha's doubt. How we calculate omega 3 at link 4? Omega 3. I've just nomenclated as omega 3. Let us suppose this is omega 3 or omega 4. The same thing. I'm taken it as the nomenclature. Okay. You can take it omega 3 or you can take it as omega also. Don't take it the nomenclature. It is basically the rotation of this link. Clear? Just do one thing. Those who want to solve this by using graphical approach, take any configuration of the link. Fine. Try to calculate the velocity, you'll be getting the answer. Okay. If not, tell me, we'll be discussing again in the series of classes. Clear? If you want, I can give you one homework, home task, so that you can give me the final answer from your side. I'll be drawing the diagram and you will be telling me the final answer. Okay. One doubt from Benny. Yes. The doubt is, we have drawn this OD. Fine, you have drawn this OD line. Fine. But we don't know the exact location of C, but we are taking that. Yes, I am taking that doubt, Benny.
I'm taking that out. Look, you have drawn this line. You have drawn this line. Let us suppose this is the dotted line. Okay. And next is the velocity of point C with respect to D will be the downward direction. What you can do, look, it's very basic. You know this direction, this is this direction. Okay, I've drawn in the dotted line. Fine, I don't know the CD, but I can, I know the velocity of this will be perpendicular to this. So I can draw a line like this. Okay. Yes, one more doubt is there. How we are defining the length of OD? Yes, definitely. You need to get this value. You need to get this value and you can, you will be giving the two velocities. One is the omega and the sliding velocity. It will be given. Sliding velocity will be given. Okay. Without that, you won't be able to get that your distance of OD. Is that clear, Benny? Is that clear? Sliding velocity, let us suppose it is given, then you can get the magnitude. Now it's okay. Fine. Now if you know this magnitude, you have got this distance. Next is rest. You have understood. Now it's clear, Benny. Because that velocity should be given. Yes, definitely. That velocity should be given or else you won't be able to draw this end point. Because this end point is necessary. If you're not getting this end point, how you can draw this straight line? Yes, very good, Benny. You need to get that because always two inputs will be given whenever you are solving any question from a graphical approach. That is, the omega will be given in the input link. Let us suppose this is the input link. Omega is given. And next thing is, or the second thing is your sliding velocity. But the direction won't be given. Direction of the sliding won't be given. That you have to, that you have to calculate. You need to understand by the movement of the links. Now it's clear, Benny? Fine. Now it's my request to all of the guys, those who are live with me, you need to solve a single problem from your side. Try to get an approach like this. Try to solve a single simple problem and try to get it used to that approach. Because sometimes what happens, a question is coming, you need to solve by relative velocity, but you land up with instantaneous method. That will only be, you can have a judging of that question will be done if you are solving more number of questions. Is that clear? In GATE examination, you are not getting that much of a problem from this topic. Yes, from incident center, you are getting some question from 1 marks. That is only for 1 marks. But for 2 marks, you're not getting. Yes, for ESE, you can get question. And for conventional, definitely a question will be there from this topic. Okay. So this was it. So now you have understood the two approaches, how to calculate the velocity of any link by using either instantaneous method or the graphical approach. It's up to you. You can approach by both the methods. And always try to solve some problems from this. Because if you are solving within 1 or 2 days this topic, that will be ready for the exam. It will be exam ready. If you are solving a question, it because this is now fresh in your minds, how to apply, how to draw the velocity triangle. After, like if you are solving a problem after a week, then it will be difficult for you to understand. Yes, now... having a doubt, it will be given, it will be given, it will be given in the problem, okay? At the input link, it will be given whether it's a clockwise or a counterclockwise. Clear? Fine. Understood? It will be given in the problem. Let us suppose OA link is moving in a counterclockwise direction at an angular velocity of 50 radian per second. That will be definitely given with a sliding velocity of 10 meter per second. Calculate the velocity of link B with respect to point A. That you can easily calculate by using this approach. Or if you want, you can solve it by instantaneous method, but it will be very difficult for you. Why? Because there are six links. There are six links. Tell me how many ICs will be there. If there are six links in this diagram, tell me how many ICs will be there. That will be 6 into 5 by 2,
15 ICs will be there. 15 ICs mean you need to locate all the ICs for getting that velocity. That is a very difficult task. If you want to solve this problem by instantaneous center method, that is very difficult. Why? Because you need to locate 15 ICs. At least you need to locate 10 ICs for getting that angular velocity. Okay, so that is why it is very difficult for solving a problem by using instantaneous method whenever you are having more than 4 number of links. Okay, so it is always preferred if you are having more than 4 number of links, you need to prefer relative velocity method. If you are having 4 number of links, definitely you should be going instantaneous center method. But if you are having a configuration like this, in that case, relative velocity is best. Fine. Give us a problem till this. Take any book. You can take what you can do. You can take a solve problem from S.S. Ratan. It's a very good book. Just take a problem, try to solve it from this textbook, and try to solve a problem. And if you're not able to get it, do let me know. And you can post it on the Grader platform. I'll be definitely help you out. And one more thing, like all of you know about the corona disease, I would like you to be safe. Don't use that much of public transportation, because that is it is growing exponentially. So it's request, it's you can stay at your home, you can prepare for the examination by staying at the home. There are platform, the GradeUp is also giving you live classes every day. So you just need to stay at home, don't go out. Many of the colleges are closed, many of the malls are closed, one of the public transportation is being closed, or it is less number of people are going for the public transport. So I request all of you to don't use any public transportation right now for at least till 31st of March, because, and for the classes, like we are helping you out for the question session or any doubt, we are there for you guys. So just go for online, that's helping you guys. Fine, thank you guys, that's what it. And I would like to introduce, there's a sale going on for the online like the course which we have launched, the course launch, a flat 40% off is there for our Vision 2021 class. Like I've told you, a 40% flat, this off is going on a flat. So there is no criteria for this. You can definitely avail 40% flat without any requirement. Okay, fine. I hope so. Now it's clear. Hello, Srishti. And this is your Vision 2021 course. This is a complete 1 year course for your ESC and your GATE examination. And now at present, fluid mechanics class is going on. So you can switch to the GradeUp app. You can enjoy the live classes. A free trial is going on. I'm not saying you to buy, I'm just telling you to, you can experience the live classes. If you are going, or if you're willing to buy it, definitely you can buy it, and you know about this deal also. Okay, thank you guys. And about the your scholarship, 50% is there for GATE qualified for 17, 18, 19, 20 IIT, NIT's government BTEC students. ESC prelims qualified. For more info, you can contact this number. This is your email ID for this is Mr. Anand Pandey, who can contact you. Tomorrow we'll be having a class of post GATE, like what to do after GATE. And I want everyone to be live at 9 o'clock, because many of the students don't know what to do after getting this much of score. So we'll be having some discussion. If you're having this score, what should you should do? If you're not qualified GATE, what you should do? If you're just qualified GATE with the border marks, what you should do? So we'll be having a discussion tomorrow, 9 o'clock. We won't be having any theory of machine tomorrow. We'll be having a discussion on this topic of GATE 2020 post a GATE discussion. Clear? Thank you guys. It was awesome from you guys. I want everyone to please share this session, like this, and subscribe to this channel, so that whenever we are having any classes, any of the classes, not me, any faculty is taking any class, you'll be getting the live notification. Fine, thank you. And one of the students asked me a book. Yes, Justin, SS Ratan, you can prefer SS Ratan. It's a very good book for theory of machine. For this topic, especially for velocity analysis, you can take up some solve examples. Try to solve it from your side. Fine. And if you are feeling any difficulties, just you can post me the doubt in the grade up doubt section, or else you can mail me to this mail ID. I am there available for you guys. suraj.gopi@gradeup.co. Okay, so I'm there for you guys. You can mail me if you want, if you're feeling any difficulty. And SS Ratan is the best book for theory of machine. Fine, thank you guys. Now let us conclude the session, and I hope so all of the doubts are cleared. So thank you Rahul, Srushti, Rashad, Prakash, Justin. So let us close this session. This is Sura signing off. Thank you and stay safe. Be at your home. Don't travel that much. And prep smart, score better, go get up. Thank you. Bye-bye.